That's the center of expression you already experienced today morning, the gibberish meditations, when we had a chance to express things that we couldn't maybe express from the past. It very often happens in life, especially in childhood, when we are so dependent on caretakers that sometimes we cannot say what we want to say, or you know, so we swallow down the food that when the parents want us to eat, we swallow down the expression that we want to say whenever we couldn't say our no's or our yeses. So very often this area around the throat, around the jaw, has some sort of, might have a tension or is interrupted in some ways. So through the morning expression, we already started working on this area. So before we go into the breathing session, I want to show you a few things around body work that we might use in breathing or not. And the first things that we want to focus on is the masseter, you know, into temporomandibular joint. It's the where the mandible goes into the temporalis. It's the jaw joint, and over the joint runs the thick muscle called masseter. Yeah. So one way to if you clench your jaw, you will find this thick tissue. Yeah, that's masseter, very thick. And you can either trace it down this way. So you kind of palpate and you find the soft tissue on it, and you either do it along the fibers. Or you can do cross fiber this way. That's the place where you can also trigger some emotions, usually anger. For some people, this place can trigger a lot of anger. You know, when we are angry, we clench the teeth, and that's where we store often anger. So that's one place. And you can work on it quite deeply. Another place that we work in this session is sternocleidomastoid that runs on the side of the neck. It has two heads, and the name comes from the attachment because it attaches to sternum. One head is in the sternum, one is in the clavicle, and the mastoid process, which is kind of back of the head. Yeah? So if you lift your head up, yeah, that's the SCM. So it's a thick cable-like strong muscle that we work sometimes either stretching or very often kind of go center or pinching. Yeah. Like this. You have to have soft hands again. And you have to be careful because under runs the jugular vein. So you don't want to press on the vein, you more like holding and catching the muscle. So there's different ways to do it. And another thing why we're doing it, what we talked about before, about the vagus nerve. So by working on the side of the neck, we are activating vagus nerve. It's very difficult to pinpoint vagus nerve because it's the 10th cranial nerve, and it's thin like a fishing rod. And it can run in so many variations. Everybody has different ways how it runs, so we cannot kind of pinpoint it's here or there. But in general, it's side of the neck. Yeah, so it goes side of the neck, and then it goes into the thoracic inlet, connecting with all the facial, inner ear, mouth, then connects with the heart, lungs, diaphragm, and digestive system. So it runs the branches of it runs all over. But in general, if you work on the site, you will somewhat indirectly affect the vagus nerve. So if you are on the side of the neck and you feel strong pulsating, means you're on the vein, you take your hands out, you're not in the right place. You want to slide more on the muscle. Can you sit up for a moment? Yeah, like this is good. Sometimes, you know, we work on trapezius. That's the muscle that is on the top of the shoulders. It's kind of muscle that is forming thoracic inlet around here. It runs through the head, along the spine, and scapulas. And also the clavicles. So how many of you have a tension here in the shoulders? Yeah? Yeah? And when you touch, often it's like so tense and people suffer a lot of pain here. So when there is a tension here, it is affecting also our breathing. It is affecting our thoracic inlet. So this you can do already when you have a person sitting and breathing sitting, you can already come into this area and work on the trapezius. Yeah. Either squeezing, or you can stretch it, yeah, like this, and breathe into it. Different ways to work, but it really likes deep work. So sometimes laying down we cannot reach it. So there are some ways sitting that you can work. Few strokes, open up the breath, and then you go into the breathing session. Yeah, to work with the trapezius. And you don't have to do all of it. This is just a few general structures that we work around this area. Maybe lay down. Okay, sure. Trachea, another thing, the windpipe. And that's sensitive area, but can be useful to know that you can actually work on the trachea. So along the way you have a kind of bone, like a horseshoe shaped bone called coracoid. No, hyoid bone. And it's the only bone that is not attached to any other bone. It's attached to muscles from the top and from the bottom. And it's protecting thyroid gland. So what you can do in some cases when there's a lot of tension here, you can softly apply stretch along the trachea. Yeah. Try to breathe into it softly. It's super sensitive, so you have to be very slow. And not with everybody you can do it. For some people, it would be too threatening to even reach there. Yeah, it can create too much fear. But for it's good to know that this is possible. It can open up a lot. The voice, the expression, the breath. And you do it both sides. It's like a tube about 2.5 centimeters. And you can work on the side. Yeah, you go all the way to the clavicle, exactly, yeah.
And you're going on the side of the trachea?
So if that is the pipe, I'm going on the side. You see that this is the tube,
yeah.
And I go on the side of this. So I'm kind of sinking in a little bit, and I'm just going on the side. Watch the body language, you know, because you will see if it's too much, there will be facial expression of sort that it's uncomfortable. You don't want discomfort. You want to do it kind of... Is that okay?
Yeah.
and you trace down towards sternum, towards clavicle. You can always sometimes work on the mandibular diaphragm, so you're going into these places here under the mandible, and you can work all this soft tissue. There are four different muscles here, and you can kind of sink in and stroke all the way, tracing mandible. That's also very powerfully opening the breath, especially that upper part, thoracic inlet. It's comfortable touch, it's soft, about 6-5, it's enough. It's a scale. She's asking about the scale, so if you take 0 to 10, 10 is like very, like too much, yeah, and 0 is, we start in a delicate touch. So there will be about 6 kind of place. It should be pleasant, it should be kind of relaxing. Okay, so those are general strokes. Let's go straight to the session. Let's just continue session. You need to mention anything before we go? All right, let's just go in. While you start breathing, you can connect to your body for a moment and tell me whenever it's a place of resource, where you feel more resourced in the body. Okay. So again, this session is about expression, about connecting to your throat. Connecting to all the times that you couldn't say what you wanted to say. And coming to deep, connected breath. see Connor's breath. It's somewhat moving through the diaphragm, moving somewhat here, but it's still not reaching fully to the top. And it's kind of fragmented in this part. It's not much movement here. Just breathe to the top of the, yeah, great. Contact with your neck, is it okay? So I'm gonna squeeze a little bit back of the neck. Some tremor around your mouth and your feet. What's happening?
Yeah, just some subtle movements here.
In the jaw. So bring awareness to this subtle movement around the jaw, around the back. Push your feet slowly, bringing awareness to this movement coming from your pelvis, pushing out. And then if you watch the body language, what are you picking emotionally? Starts going into some movement, so allow this movement to happen. That's great. Mm. some expression, because your mouth is opening, but give it also expression. Give it any sort of sound that wants to come with it. Connected sounds within the resource. If something wants to come, allow the sound. It could be gibberish, it could be whatever, a vowel. Express that emotion now, some strong emotion coming up. Let your body express that. Thank you. connected breath. Yeah, good. A few more. Your body move with it. It's a lot of energy. Now let your body move and connect with the sound, connect with your throat with it. Energy, I would like to discharge you. So what are we gonna do? I would like to invite you, if this is right for you, go on the fours, go on the hands and on the, yeah, on the fours. Just turn around, and if this is right for you, go on the fours. Good. And I invite you to, on inhalation, bring the head up, and on exhalation, bring the head down. Bring that spinal movement. I invite you to, in this session, to also spit out, keep your tongues out, and whatever wants to come out from your mouth, from your tongue, you can just let it out in front of you. So all these times where you had to swallow things, you couldn't say, this is all now, have a chance to come out. So keep your tongues out. Breathe and let all this content out with the movement. Yeah, good. Thank you. this energy to get expressed in a way that you can make some vocal sound also from this place. If there's any sound that you think of, what is the sound of energy? Let it express. Because you have so much energy right now. So what is the sound of this? From this place. Express that energy, yeah. All this shake, all this tremor, give it a sound, give it a sound. Yeah, make a sound. Grounded, ground this energy cord into the earth, into the feet. touching earth with your resource. How does that feel? share anything. Speak up.
Sorry. I actually forgot you were over here. that sort of energy that was, it was all real creative. And it feels like it's the purest, most truest form of me. And like being a regular serious human is going against it. That needs to show itself creatively, music and art.
Mm-hmm.
I was sad because I wasn't, I possibly may not be using it to its full potential.
And it's familiar, like what's happening in your life?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very, very familiar. None of that session was about like me it's hard to explain. Like the part where you said like swallowing orders and taking things and not speaking. That doesn't affect me. It's the other side of it where I have something inside that I'm not
expressing out.
Slowly, but because it's peculiar for a lot of people,
mm-hmm.
It's not the most easily shared thing. music is an art is the only way I've found to be able to let it flow.
See that? You have like a big heart, beautiful energy. Yeah. All right, so we're gonna go.